With the blue function complete, the interpreter jumps back out to where that function was called, and the current context moves out as well. Furthermore, this was all part of the first call to new Saga, which is now completed. Running the red new Saga function a second time would result in drafting a new, separate red context, which itself contained two new blue contexts. Almost all the exact same steps would occur, and although they would each happen one at a time, let's picture them all popping up at once, so that we can see them without having to run the entire simulation one line at a time. Notice that the values found in these new contexts will be entirely different, and it's actually stored in an entirely new Saga variable. Although the second Saga function was created by the same lines of code that created the first one, the two would fail a triple equals test that compared them. Creating two equivalent-looking functions, but that have different identities, is exactly like what happens when you see an array literal appearing within a function definition. Calling that function twice creates two different array objects. And so this line would log the value false, because the two array objects do not pass a triple equals comparison. The same would be true of these two function objects, because they were created by the same lines of code in two different invocations of the new Saga function. What two strings do you think would be logged as a result of this second call to the new Saga function?